So this is Gnaraloo. It's one of my favorite places in Western Australia. We can see that there's plenty of swell. The coastline is basically desert, and Gnaraloo is where the desert meets the sea. Having a look at the 3 mile campground and just where that sand patch is on the left, you can see the lagoon. Over the back of the reef at the lagoon, we can see large schools of fish, including these parrotfish. There's also a number of mobs of convict surgeon fish swimming about. They're often in large schools. Some trevally. I see a lot of trevally. So we've got some wrasse and some butterfly fish and some goat fish. This is from inside the lagoon. There goes a damsel fish across the top and another one. So we're looking at some sailfin tang there. Can't get enough of this shot. So Moorish idol with some blue damsel fish. And the water was really clear. So looks pretty nice. I think I've thrown in plenty of footage of these guys. I was pretty wrapped with it. There's lots of beautiful coral inside the lagoon. Plenty of little fish living inside them for protection. There are a lot of great spots to snorkel along the Gnaraloo coast. This spot is about a kilometre down from the 3 mile campground in the lagoon. This is Gnaraloo Bay. We can see that there is the reef pretty much right in front of us. There's a fair bit of reef, and then we've got a bit of a drop off and some sand channels going up and out to the break. They're about 5 meters across. Spent a bit of time out there because it's actually pretty good. So this is a pretty good drift snorkel. So you walk up to the left, up and around the beach, and jump in. On a clear day, you'll see some pretty beautiful coral. You'll see some dead coral, but that's pretty normal. But you'll certainly see some stunning coral. So we've got some banded humpbugs there, some butterfly fish, some monocle brim, and again, some more blue damsel fish. They tend to hide out in that staghorn coral there, but they're pretty bold when there's this many of them. It's at a place called Cape Farqua, which is pretty nice. This is a coral, and it's got its polyps out. Unusual during the day, but who knows. This one's a bit deeper, so it's not as unusual. I've been to it a couple of times. This next shot's on a different day, and we can actually see the numbers have changed. This is one at night time. Looks pretty cool, but that's standard though. That's what they usually do, is come out at night. Can't remember what these guys are. Type of damsel fish, I'm sure. Okay, there's an anemone hiding in the dead coral there. The dead coral, you know, provides a home for a lot of them. Another little sea anemone there. Okay, this is pretty sad. So this is was a massive anemone patch, but as of last year, it was no longer there. So it must have died. And it was beautiful. So you can see how many fish are swimming around it. That's not happening anymore. And there are a few anemone fish or clownfish living in it. Lots of little wrasse around. And also some little damsel fish. So, yeah, real shame, disappointing. So out the back, behind the lagoon, we've got plenty of sharks. This one's trying to see if he can munch on a barracuda. You can see that barracuda's had a bit of a munch off it. They're looking for the stranded ones. This is an interesting shot. See if you can find, there are six sharks there, grey reef and common black tips. Just looking around to see the weak fish to jump in and have a feed. This was a pretty exciting time back in 2016. I was just sitting there filming, some trevally go past, there's barracuda in the background. Get a bit shaky on the camera because I've just seen what's coming. And it's that common black tip, but it wasn't on its own. It's a shame I didn't get better footage, but there's number two. Number three, number four just down below, and I think there was a fifth one as well. So that was a pretty exciting moment. Yes, this is juvenile grey reef shark. He gets a bit cranky at me. You see how it's swimming and just wagging its whole body like that? That's just telling me to go away. If it puts its pectoral fins down as well, I'd be leaving it alone, but it was only a meter long. So white tips just in the lagoon. It's a bit of a stacks on there. That was back in 2015. I haven't seen that many together, but it can be about timing. So we can see how they pull water in through their mouths and they push it out through their gills so they can be stationary on the bottom. There's a couple at night time, just hiding in the coral. They'll come out later on and hunt some parrotfish. And there's three in this shot as well. You can see that the third one, just a little bit deeper in. This guy little buzz me at night. I don't see them that often at night, but occasionally I do. We ran into some trouble here, me and this poor little shark. I spent a few minutes following it. I wasn't paying attention to where I was. It probably had a better idea of where we were. It took me up into the reef. So it's pretty shallow and it got a bit trapped. And then it didn't know I was there and decided, bingo. I don't know. I actually don't remember if we made contact with each other. I think I managed to get out of its way. It's got sensory organs on its nose, so it may have avoided me more than I avoided it. I got out of the way and let it come out. Yeah, good sport. Here's a big tawny. There's a bit of swell up, or a bit of surge, I should say. Just pushing it around a little bit. Is it holding on with its mouth? I don't know. So I thought, okay, why not? Go for a closer look. Tawnies are harmless. And it just went up. Has a little notch in its tail. This is the same tawny, but 4 years later. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, this one was pretty hospitable. Let me get right up, and I'm basically, it's not an illusion, I'm pretty much on top of it there. Just keeping an eye out to see whether it's distressed and being nice and quiet. It did move around a bit. Okay, I'm down a hole that's in about 4 meters, and it was about a meter across at the top, and I thought I'd just jump down and have a look, and I found this girl. This tawny doesn't know that I'm there. It's just cruising. Does a bit of a turn. Knows something is there. So decide, I'm like really still and quiet. Comes in and then it just goes, oh crap. Sharks are pretty risk averse. Anything that they think is big enough to hurt them, they will avoid. Lots of wobbegongs. I think I've seen six different species of wobbegong. Up at Gnaraloo, I think I've seen something where like 14 different species of shark. So this is a tasseled wobbegong. It's just lying. That's an ambush predator. I took my eyes off it. And then I looked in the distance and saw she was having a swim. She's got a massive waist there. I don't know if she's just fat or whether or not she's got some pups. But beautiful shot. I really love this one. Can see the lights reflecting off the surface onto her back, giving us a bit of an effect. And she was just great. She didn't swim too fast. She didn't like me being there, but I don't think she found it a very big deal. And we can see how well camouflaged she is just in a moment when she parks on the sand. You know she's there, but I tell you, if you're swimming and not paying attention, wouldn't see her. Now this is a tasseled wobbegong as well, but we can see very different colors during the day. So it's trying to match the reef. Just amazing pattern. Again, unusual to see one swimming around, but pretty cool. And that one's parked there, so difficult to see again. Wow, this is probably my favorite animal. There's a few that go into the lagoon. They go in the late afternoon and they're in there at night time, so it suggests they're out hunting during the day. So it's called a guitar fish. So a massive dorsal fin, and then it's got a second dorsal fin, and then a big crescent tail. It looks a bit like a shovel nose, but it's not a shovel nose. So this one's about 2 meters long, about 70 kilos. So it's a big animal. They bury themselves in the sand like a stingray. I don't know what that golden trevally's doing. It's like giving it a bite. look, that's just a gorgeous animal, isn't it? Gives a bit of a stomp with its pectoral fin. That's it telling me, communicating to me that it's not too happy. I don't chase them too often. I just kind of keep my distance, come at an angle. Here we have some eagle rays. Sometimes fishermen cut their tails off, which is a shame. So the one on the right looks like it's been ripped off. This one has part of its tail, it's still pretty short. It's got a bit of a posse, not very many, he's got two out the front. I thought it would be a bit of fun, ended up with my own. It's kind of funny, but then sometimes it gets completely in the way. This is a juvenile and it still has its tail. I think they can get up to something like 9 feet long, which is pretty amazing. This is a cowtail ray. Follow this one around a little bit. It decided it's going to bury itself. I like its little finish. Just here. little mask ray here. At night, obviously. Don't see these guys too often. It's a smooth ray. I've seen about three up on the Ningaloo Reef. Of course, I've got the lights, and I'm behind the lights, and it doesn't know that I'm there. It probably just thinks it's reflection off some fish scales or something like that, or doesn't even think about what it is. It's just doing its thing. Blue-spotted mask ray. These guys are pretty cool. They run away during the day, but at night, they're pretty curious about the lights on the camera. Certainly, they're not intimidated by them. See, this one's a bit curious, having a bit of a munch there, and then realises that the camera is there, so it would have some sensory organs that wouldn't have been able to see it because the lights are too bright. Having a bit of a feed. Off it goes. This turtle's gorgeous. This is a green sea turtle. Pretty accommodating again. Ended up swimming away. This is at Cape Farquhar as well. It's a big green sea turtle. It's breeding time. And there were actually four big ones, probably about 80 centimeter shell on these guys. You know if they're a boy. Yeah, that's definitely a boy over there. It's got that really long tail. This one's male as well, but he's only got a little one. So he's probably younger than the big one that was over there. Lovely little green again. This was a big surprise. So in the lagoon at night time, last thing you expect to see is a massive loggerhead. So that shell's probably, it was around 1.2 meters. Like this animal was certainly much heavier than me. So talking upwards of 200 kilos, massive animal, nice little green at night. I try not to wake them up too much, but every now and again, accidentally, you know, cause I don't always see stuff until I'm right on top of it. If they're just chilling and cruising around like that, I might follow them for a while, but sometimes they start swimming around in circles really fast and get a bit panicked. So when that happens, I clear out, certainly turn the lights away from them. Anything with those blue damselfish in the background looks good. Okay, this is a big loggerhead. So this is in one of those sand channels up at Gnaraloo Bay. I woke this one up the day before accidentally, and it panicked, and I hung around it for an hour and it just didn't wake up. I wasn't game to try and wake it up. This is a little loggerhead. Lost its fin, unfortunately. There's two of them together. I thought this was a lovely moment. The one at the top didn't hang around though. He saw me and he nicked off in a bit of a panic. But this guy, super accommodating. Hopefully it wasn't sick. I don't think it was, because it had no trouble swimming, just chose not to. So you can see that back right, obviously lost it to a shark. This is the skull of a humpback whale. So they do their migration. Would have been a good 3 meters across. So we can see the lagoon that I go in at night time, then there's a reef, and then just to the right we can see out the back, and that's where I go when I say I'm out the back of the reef. That's the three mile campground. You can see that it's a desert. Man, we can see down the bottom. It's a bit deeper out there. Beautiful animal, harlequin snake eel. It's not a snake. It's got a characteristic called aposematism, which means it's kind of posing as a snake, so nothing bites it. So it's evolved to have those characteristics. This is a conger eel. I've only ever seen three. I kind of scared this guy out from his hole. Yeah, pretty awkward. Kept crashing into everything. So I kind of felt a little bit bad for it. So I didn't try to get too close. They're beautiful animals. I really like them. It's a shame I haven't seen more. Pretty long. Good meter or so. See you later. Here's another one. Just that tail. Now we're getting into the mores. That black smooth ray actually swam right over the top of it. It wasn't happy about that, and then it had me coming and getting in its face. They open their mouths nice and wide, like this guy, to say, look how big my mouth is, you better stay away. This one was super fat. This is a different one, but same species. Just love the way they curl through the coral. So this is a white-mouthed moray. It's got some food stuck in there, but stunning. Almost doesn't look real. This one's posturing. Yep. Telling me to go away. Certainly telling me to go away. Don't put your fingers near it. A little grey-faced moray. They're tiny, they're about 30 centimetres long. But pretty cute. Sometimes you see a few of them together. I followed that one, and then it went and had a crack at what was in that shell. When I saw it happen, I thought it was having a crack at a hermit crab. But it's not, it's actually pulling the snail out. Trying to eat it. We can see some hermit crabs over to the right there. And when I thought it was a hermit crab, I thought, what are these guys doing? But the hermit crabs were not intimidated one bit. Greyface moray provides homes for the hermit crab by killing the snail. What a risk taker. This guy is pretty cute. Have a look at that. This one's got some anemones on it. This one's bitten off more than it can chew. Have a look at the size of that shell. Hope you like cuttlefish. Because I do. We're about to look at about a million of them. All the same species. Just cephalopods are the masters of camouflage. I don't know what this one is trying to be. Like, it's trying to camouflage and hide, but you tell me what it's trying to be. This one's a bit clearer. Definitely matching that weed. Nice change of colour. This is insane. Thinks it's a bit of a hypnotist. Obviously something under that coral. Yep, wants to go. Nope, got to pull out. Must have moved back. So it's just trying to dazzle it and confuse it. Okay, making its decision. I wonder what it is. Because it's got to work that hard to get it out. Maybe a crab? Oh, have a look at this. Oh, I missed him. This one doesn't. Bang. Yeah, just love a little change of colour. Look at that psychedelic black striping going on. Nice shot, this one. Okay, so this one's given some white spots. Really red, so it's not trying to hide. There's this bloke and his girlfriend. There's some fun and games going on between these three. Bit of chasey. Yeah, bit of posturing here. He wants a bit of her. She's gone nut. Clearing out. There was so much surge and swell on this one. It was actually pretty hard for me to stay stable, and that was unfortunate because of this situation. So I thought there was two under there, but there wasn't. Have a look at this. No, that is not a cuttlefish with two bums. He's got her by the face. How romantic. She's not trying to get away. I don't know if this is breeding. I really don't know. It's something. Yep, she's had enough. Yep, and he releases. Big fin roof squid. Amazing animal. Sometimes I don't see any, sometimes I see plenty. There it goes. Yeah, it's hunting. It's a bit out of focus. Pulls something really silver, so it must have been a little fish. All right, this one's got a bit of a catch. It's got a long tongue. Looks like it's kind of broken its neck. It's certainly not alive. Just a reef octopus. Pretty cool. Lands on fish. So the next few bits of footage are all the same octopus. Again, doesn't know what's behind the lights. So more than happy to come and say good day. Have a bit of a walk. Who needs to swim when you got eight legs? Starry night octopus. Seen three, and one of them was about 5 centimeters. Have a look at this. So it plonks itself down, sends all those tentacles out. Just feeling. Amazing. So when it finds something, all the tentacles go down the hole. Have a look at this. Blowing water in there. So water jets trying to flush out all of the sand so I can grab its dinner. Yeah, just ridiculous. Amazing animal. Goatfish. So it's got some appendages, some organs on the front. There's sensory organs, so we'll put those down in the sand. And when it picks up some electrical signals, chucks its head in and just sucks it all out. Little boxfish, pretty cute. That is a pufferfish. So I got a few pufferfish coming up. I don't always know what they're called. Don't eat them. I think that one's called a starry pufferfish. Lined pufferfish? I don't know, just making that up. Black spotted rock cod. This is a juvenile batfish. It lives in the lagoon. See it quite often during the day. But looks spectacular at night time. Some blue stripe cleaner wrasse. Same spot, different year. These are some yellow rabbit fish. So this is a queenie, swim along with its mouth open. No idea what it's doing. So this is a sea hare. This is their mode of transport. I'm not kidding. I've seen it numerous times. They just jump in the current. They've got those big flaps on them, kind of like a snail, but they've got the shell on the inside. Never in a hurry. I'm guessing they don't taste very nice. They're well camouflaged though. We've got these two lovebirds. Almost impossible to get in focus, but pretty cool. It's a little flatworm. Very charming. What he does at the end is pretty interesting. Goes and grabs onto the coral and then just tries to look like a bit of weed. Good strategy. Spanish dancer. Seen half a dozen of these. Pretty big, good 20 centimeters long. Never seen one swimming though. This is a big nudibranch as well. No idea what species. It was every bit as big as the Spanish dancer. This is a feather star. They can swim, they're an animal. Never seen one swimming though. So it attaches itself and then puts up those appendages. This is a type of sea cucumber, unusually enough. And it's got those appendages out the front and it's just sifting its way through. So there's the lagoon and the reef, and we can see out the back. You can see why I go in there at night time, because there's not a lot of ways in, particularly at low tide. I'm pretty well protected. It really is a beautiful place.